All right, we're live.
Check, check. Oh, yeah. Volume levels are crazy good.
Cameras.
Okay. Camcorder.
No, just this camera, bro.
We'll turn it to that one. You want it off the smartphone.
Yeah.
Go ahead and talk.
Check, microphone, check, check, microphone, check, bitches.
Okay.
Bitches get stitches.
Wow. Starting off with anger.
No, I'm not angry. I mean, I've been dealing with that actually this week.
What?
Well, just because...
Anger issues or bitches with stitches?
I guess kind of both, it seems like. Maybe both.
Do I want to know?
No. I mean, you know how it ebbs and flows, how you're like super hyped, and then sometimes you get a little just like... Brah.
Well, it's called life, especially when you deal with like depression or anxiety.
Yeah.
That's
so, just a little... I think, like I said, the weather too. It's been cold in the mornings. It's super foggy.
Right.
And it's like...
The fog has been gnarly up where I live, too.
I bet, dude.
We're kind of down in, like, this little canyon, so it gets really foggy. So we can literally, like, on the drive to Sammy's school, we're in it at home, we leave it, and then over by his school, it's soup again.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Where we live, right there on Crocker, it sits... At, like, our neighbor's house sits in the little... Holler.
Yeah, it's a holler.
and it's so foggy just right around our house.
Yeah, you know what's funny? The weather doesn't bum me out. It's the, like, I don't feel like, shorts and a t-shirt outside, chilling.
I just want to stay in the fucking house, dude.
Right.
I would stay in my pajamas.
That's the part I don't like.
Chill out. Smoke a little weed.
Weed!
Chill. Hang. So, no, just, but then, also, I mean, making the statement last week, you know, it's hard to think like I think sometimes because it's people give me shit for it.
Did you get shit from last week's podcast?
Not necessarily, but it's like giving my own shelf shit. But like I judge myself.
Oh, but that's I think you're like me in that sense, is that you're very self-critical.
Yeah,
and especially if you go back, like I won't go back and read anything that I've written for a blog, and I won't go back and watch any podcast because it's like I know I'm going to be like, fuck, dude, why did I say that?
Or,
why didn't I go further with that? Or,
yeah.
I don't know.
So,
anyway, so we have new mics on. So
microphone check, check, microphone check.
Das Effects, wasn't that one of their songs?
Das Effects.
Yeah, so the sound should be way better. See the sound bar?
Yo, dude, that thing's going off the fucking charts.
It's a horny as shit, dude.
Damn, it's hard, it's soft, it's hard, it's soft. It's big, it's small, it's big, it's small.
Can you watch?
Yeah.
Sorry
guys. But so, then people, you know that, and just I'm just really trying to read and listen to. Like this whole week, I've been squeezing cans, so I've been listening to so many fucking podcasts, dude.
I saw you post on. When you post on Twitter, is that you posting on Twitter, or are you sending it from Facebook?
I'm sending it from Facebook.
Okay, yeah. Okay, because I saw you were talking about it was Sam Tripoli.
Yeah.
On was it Tinfoil Hats podcast?
Yeah. Yeah, his, I really enjoy his. There's this other guy, Ben, I just started listening to, and I heard about him on Sam Tripoli.
Who's Ben?
He's just this one cat out of New York. He started out doing, I think, like wrestling podcasts.
This is fucking annoying to hold.
Like doing wrestling podcasts, and then
is like wrestling, like WWE.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, like the fake wrestling.
Full, and he knows it's fake, you know. But he's like, it's kind of like I really related to it. Well, I loved wrestling as a kid.
Oh,
dude.
I did too.
Fucking
who's
loved
your favorite?
It. I had a couple favorites. I loved Ricky the Steamboat Dragon.
See, that's before me.
And that was way back. Ricky the Steamboat Dragon. I liked the Great Kabuki because he used to wear a kabuki mask, and he would spit this green stuff out of his mouth. Yeah, dude.
That seems like that could be against OSHA.
Really, this was like 1982.
Back, like they didn't give a fuck about that shit.
Yeah, it was the East Coast one.
They didn't care about what diseases were being spread.
They were just shooting steroids and just fucking getting at it.
No, I grew up like in the Andre the Giant, Hulk Hogan.
Well, I mean, Andre was around and Hulk was around, and they were still, when I first started watching it was still separate regional areas.
Oh, that's right.
For
there
wrestling.
Was never a national thing. Didn't they travel too?
Yeah, you would travel different circuits, and you would be invited maybe to go to another one.
Yeah,
Billy Corgan from Smashing Pumpkins
owns
the one up in Chicago.
Yeah, it's not the WWE one; it's the other one, the like WCW.
I'm not sure, but I'm stoked for him because it's like
he was on Rogan one time, and when he wrote, Joe goes like, "So wait, do I have this? Like, you're really into wrestling?" He goes, "Oh yeah," and I bought that division. It's like, wait, what? You just do that?
Yeah, you totally can't when you got enough money. I mean, those small regional ones.
Yeah, they're not that much money.
Yeah, so
Ben.
But he talks about like a lot. Well, he talks about like just dark arts that are involved with sports and shit like that, and like, exposing
what do you mean, like, sports.
Just the way they're trying to reprogram kids
through sports.
Yeah, just different symbolisms and things like that.
Like what? You have an example or no?
They say that LeBron does this. I haven't really started getting into that stuff yet.
About LeBron, what?
He just, everybody just does symbolisms the way that they're promoting, like, well, the NFL is promoting, like, don't fucking say a word to anything. I mean, or you're going to be out of the league.
Yeah, did you see, who was that football player that got kicked off his team? Because somebody was giving this football, like, he was like a safety or a wide receiver on the New York Giants football team. And on Twitter, somebody was giving him shit. And he was like, well, dude, it's like a team effort. And
well, that's the whole thing with the Dodgers, dude. What the fuck, dude?
Well, got fucked by Houston.
Fucking, fuck you, Houston.
What do you
fuck watch? You.
Hi, guys.
Hey, buddy.
That
was just ruthless. Because remember the games when they were banging on the fucking trash cans, dude? And you're like, what the fuck?
Well, so now the other one that hasn't been confirmed yet, but has been...
the midget fucking...
No, the buzzers. It's him and that other dude had was apparently on their back arm.
Yeah.
Had like a buzzer.
Yeah, and so they would know what
which
the pitch
is why
was.
The conspiracy theory is that when Altuve was coming in after that home run and he was holding his shirt and he was like, no.
Don't take my shirt off. Don't take my shirt off.
You go back and some dude put this on.
I saw the thing on his arm.
No, I get it. That too, but it's worse. If you go back in slow motion, read his mouth, it looks like he says, like, I have a piece on. Don't take my shirt off when he came in like that. It's like, because I didn't pay attention to
a bunch of fucking cheaters, dude. That just I know that everybody steals signs, but it's like, you guys were fucking doing it in the
stealing signs is normal with your eyeballs and you're trying to, like,
you're signaling. That's fucking,
I think that's fair. Here's where I think it's fair. I think it's fair if I'm on second base and you're up to bat and the catcher just threw a sign and I know that it's a fastball and I give you a hand signal that lets you know it's
going to be
fastball.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
But if you're using technology,
yeah.
Fuck you. Buzzers, technology of any sort.
Yeah. Wrong.
So what do they do though? You know how so Pete Rose is banned for life
because he's banned on think baseball? All those fucking players
should
dude,
he be let back in then?
I think they should all be, if they let him back in, you got to let Pete Rose in. You gotta let him back in and get his chance to get in the Hall of Fame.
No shit.
And then
he deserves it.
He was fucking awesome, dude.
Yeah,
he had a gambling problem. All these motherfuckers.
I have a drinking problem.
Everybody has some kind of problem.
Right, T? What kind of
everybody's
problem
got an issue.
Do you have an issue, T?
No.
No? Just with this guy?
I mean, look at Aaron's neck.
Yeah,
well,
that's a problem. I kind of see those people thought it was
a
big problem.
Suicide?
Yeah, allegedly.
In prison or out?
Allegedly.
Yeah. Oh,
him like, and Epstein, bro.
Yeah.
Like
Epstein.
So I think
strip the fucking. He should be allowed in. They need to strip the title from fucking the Astros because it's like, fuck you guys, man.
Well, I think what?
Look at the 1918 White Sox or whatever.
Oh, yeah,
were
yeah,
banned.
Yeah. Well,
their whole fucking team was banned for fixing the game.
They were throwing games.
They were cheating.
Yeah.
Same fucking thing.
Right. Dude, I don't know, man. It's it'll be interesting because so far the punishments have been pretty weak.
They're pissed.
The guy the Mets hired to be their head coach, they fired before he ever coached a game. It was that
he
was
he guy. Played with yeah. the fucking Dodgers.
No,
that's
with Astros.
But well, he was
involved with the Astros cheating.
For sure, but he before that he was a player for the Dodgers.
Oh, was he?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't remember.
And so,
do you like so dark art in relation to sports? Is you think sports are
they push a false? I think they push a false narrative on what heroes are. But that's just my own. That's my opinion.
I agree.
So, like I said, I haven't really listened to all of that. So, I mean, I listened to one episode and. They just, I mean, they say...
No, but I agree with what you're saying because I think in sports, like anything, anywhere, you know, the royal family, sports, politicians, corporations, marketing, like even the marketing Tin City Cider does, you're trying to do something. You're trying to, like, oh, look at this coloring, or you go into a mall and they used to, like, put scents, fragrances in the air
that
like, make you, like, hungry or make you this. Like, there's all this, like, I mean, that's all we do as humans is try to fuck the next person mentally. It seems like
weird, super weird.
But when you get into sports or like politics,
which to me it's all a game. But they've made a game like they've it's
inside
the whole.
It's a game in the game.
It's a game in a game, and it's a trip. I mean, like I'm gonna check into it more. Like I said, I can't talk about it a whole lot because I don't know.
Right. So you don't know his last name though. It's Ben something.
I'll look it up right now.
Because
I like it. Yeah, I found him. He's on Podbean, that one I told you about, the new.
I started looking at that. Is that the thing that you thought would be able to cut up clips, or was that a separate issue in your mind?
That was just a separate... What?
What happened?
My son's going to the East Coast.
Oh, you have new glass, bro.
Yeah, dude.
You're looking all official.
Don't make me drop it. Don't make me drop it. Podbean, podcast on the go.
Yeah, so I have that saved to get into more.
Let's see who my playlists... Is it the Infinite Branch?
So what about Sam Tripoli? What's his thing? Is he a conspiracy theory guy?
Yeah, like totally. He like, totally is.
Is it Flat Earth?
Is it the Infinite Branch? Oh, this is one I started. I don't know if this is the dude, but this is the Infinite Fringe, is what I started listening to on here.
You're getting into conspiracy theories shit ton, like hardcore.
Some of them. I mean, some of them are just silly, dude.
Well, does Sam Tripoli believe in Flat Earth?
He's not convinced, but he's not convinced.
Jesus fucking
He's not convinced, but he's not convinced.
We live on a globe. Sasquatch does not, or whatever, Yeti doesn't exist.
I don't know about that either, dude.
Oh, there's no way. There'd be fucking bodies found, dude. Shit.
No, not that. Let's see. Where am I at? I'm sorry, dude.
That's...
Tinfoil hats. Okay, let's see. Billy Ray Valentine is the guy's name.
Wasn't that the guy, Billy Ray Valentine? Wasn't that the name of a character?
Yeah, it was Eddie Murphy's character.
Billy Ray Valentine?
Trading Places, but that's this guy's name. He's out of the Bronx.
Oh my God,
and this is, so I started listening to it, but I'd have to go in and listen to it again. I find them interesting, you know? I find, like, all the connections to different people super interesting.
Right. Well, I think it's interesting because of all the conspiracy theories, let's say there's 100, I think 11 of them are true. And
no, I think more than that, dude. See, I think more than that are.
11%.
I'm way more than that, dude. I'm way more than that.
Okay, how about this? Flat Earth, yes or no?
No, I don't believe that one yet.
Okay, so Epstein was suicided in prison. I agree with that. I believe that
he was suicided. Yeah, he didn't do it himself.
No, that's why I say suicided.
Yeah, he didn't do it himself. I'm totally fucking on board with that shit.
That is a complete conspiracy theory that's real.
It's real, but
it's worse than we think.
It's
too.
Super. It's like all the connections to the people in government. It just blows my mind and how he was involved with like CIA and he was involved with fucking Israeli intelligence and.
But you know what I figure is happening, and I've heard people talk about it a little bit, is I think he was this rich guy, however he got rich, and then as he would bring people in because they wanted a hooker or they wanted like a 14-year-old, he would basically video them or have documentation to then hold over their head, to which then allowed him to get into even higher places of power.
He got into weird places, like things just happened for him, and you're like, why the fuck did that happen to that dude?
Right.
It's like, what is going on with him? But like he was a middle class, he was from a middle class.
How did a dude like Jabba the Hutt get Princess Leia? He fucking stole her and chained her to him.
Yeah, she was chained.
Right, but that's like a guy like that ain't gonna get that.
No, there's just too many shenanigans going on, you know.
It's
so
fucking crazy, man.
But yeah, that one he was totally suicided.
Do you think the Clintons are like, holy fuck, man, he's dead. So who has power over the videos and all the shit?
They do.
Who does?
The Clintons and whoever else is involved with that shit.
I think Epstein had all that to use over them.
He did have it, but somebody else has it. They went in and swept his fucking island, all of his homes, dude. They went in and cleared those places out.
So somebody's got it.
Somebody's got it.
Well, and it actually behooves the people in power that are going to look for that shit to keep it hidden, because they're in it too. Whether it's CIA or, I don't know, it's so fucking, I literally, between Trump and the Epstein case, I have become 100 times more skeptical than I was 2 years ago.
Yeah, I'm pretty skeptical.
Have you always been?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
Is it because you, like, have you always been conspiracy minded then? Or
I believe so, since I was a little kid, probably.
Was that because, like, your parents?
No, my dad was in the Navy. He was a CB in the Navy, so he was a mechanic.
Mm-hmm.
20 years. He never really, I mean, he was that typical dad, you know, he didn't really drink that much. Once in a while, he'd have a drink,
right.
Smoke cigs, would work at his buddy's shop, you know, when he wasn't working in the daytime.
Well, so he was a go-getter.
Fucking super go-getter.
But he wasn't that way? Conspiracy-minded?
I think later in his life he got that way, because my brother said, like, when my dad passed away, we went out to his house. in Wyoming. He had guns hidden everywhere. Hi, Melissa. He had guns hidden everywhere.
Really?
Yeah. So he was
like gnarly guns or just kind of like pistols and shit?
Pistols, rifles, stuff he made. Rifles he made. My dad was that type. He could hone his own fucking guns and shit.
That's how Annie's dad can make guns.
It's fucking, I've given my son a couple knives that my dad made. Oh, fucking beautiful knives.
What kind
of
handle?
One of them is, it's some kind of bone. It's either that's elk so cool. or something. But it's the way the knife is shaped.
Right.
It's shaped like this almost. So it got you real good.
Wow, you're prepared, bro. I hope your son doesn't do
I've always been like that. But I just, you know, like I said, I haven't been into it for a long time. And now I get into it and I'll listen to stuff. But I don't want to just listen to strictly that. Lisa's getting way into podcasts. She's way into the Kristen Smart one right now.
The what?
There's a Kristen Smart podcast.
Oh, yeah, she's been posting stuff about that. I lost interest in that stuff a long time ago. Sorry, that's not me being a dick.
Yeah. I remember it because I lived in San Luis when all that happened.
It was crazy, right? Mm-hmm. What year was that roughly? Early 90s?
95.
Oh, okay. 95. So how was that? Like, did that just... It shook the community, right?
Totally shook the community.
So she's the one that...
Disappeared,
never
gone.
Never was found.
Never.
Body never found.
Never found.
Who am I getting confused with?
You're getting it with Rachel Newhouse and...
No, a different one. Another name.
Another gal. Well, Rex Krebs.
Yeah, that dude, right?
He was the one who... kidnapped and killed the two gals and buried them out.
Isn't there
in the canyon?
There was a girl that was got out safely, but it was this old dude and his wife had this girl.
That was up north.
Yeah, that's the one I'm thinking.
The
about
girl had part. He had she had kids and stuff.
I think so.
Yeah.
Smart.
No, I don't remember.
So 95, it shook the community. You remember that pretty vividly.
Yeah, totally. And then right after that. Was the other one happened where the gals disappeared and people were fucking tripping balls.
That's so weird. Like, just that whole... I was listening to Rogan with... he had Jimmy Dore on.
Dude, that guy's awesome. I'd never listened to him before.
Yeah, I've listened to him a couple
times. My friends who are totally trying to convince me to be Democratic, go listen to Jimmy fucking Dore.
And he's a definite Democrat.
He's a definite... And so listen to him.
He calls shit all on the Democrats, too.
I know, and that's why, you know...
I'll say... So, and then today I finished listening to Rogan with Bill Maher, who I'm typically not a fan of, because I think he's far left.
But he's totally changed, dude.
He's talking... Even in today's podcast with Rogan, he was talking a lot of shit about... Democrats, and like I said, I'm an independent. Like, I believe people should have guns, so that's a right side. On the left side, I don't give a fuck who you marry, and I think we should also like help people that are less fortunate if they want help, and if we can give them a helping hand to let them move up and do their own thing.
Yeah.
But Jimmy Dore is a fascinating motherfucker. But they were talking about everything from like how, you know, people get into these positions of power, like Bill Cosby, Michael Jackson.
Oh,
Clinton,
yeah.
Epstein. Think about all these.
And then they think that they
guys.
Get a sense of completely, they're completely above and.
Right. That it's even, almost like they become like delusional, like nothing, the law and how other people's like humanness
doesn't matter.
Affect them anymore.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Right.
Is what it is. Right. It's like you don't matter.
But it's like they get it so ingrained in their brain, like they actually, like that's just. How they think now.
Yeah.
Well, because Rogan was making the point that like Bill Cosby's been famous since the 50s.
Yeah, I loved him, dude.
Right.
Fucking loved
Most
him.
Most people did.
I loved Fat Albert, dude, when I was a kid.
Mushmouth,
all those dudes.
But yeah, he was talking about, you know, when you're that famous, Michael Jackson, famous for so long and went fucking crazy. Britney Spears, famous really young, lost her fucking mind.
Justin Bieber kind of losing his mind.
He did, and now he seems to be kind of coming back a little bit. Just like Britney Spears seems to have leveled out a little bit. But yeah, it's weird, man, when you get into those positions of power like that.
Crazy.
There is so much shit out there in the world that I don't even want to know about.
I don't either, dude. You know?
Well, it's like, so Cosby's been like drugging and raping people for decades.
Decades, dude.
They call him
at least 40 years, man.
Don't they call him? He's like the most prolific serial rapist of all time. Although I don't know if they're talking about Genghis Khan and shit, because that guy.
I don't know. I mean, he got at it, man.
It's fucking insane.
But that's so. That's all dark arts.
Isn't that weird, man? Do you think more people are believing it, or do you think more people just want to go about their daily life and don't even put thought into it?
I just think people are just going to go about their daily life and don't put thought
into it. I got bills to pay. I got to pick my kid up.
Yeah, I don't want to hear your shit. And it's like, all right, that's cool.
I'm like you, though, man. It's like to be informed and like listening to people on the left and the right.
Well, I just want
to
be informed, you know. Right. And I have people who are like, you know, I posted some libertarian meme. And people were like, that's laughably dangerous.
And then they're like, Trump 2020.
Well, that was fucking Bobby Aguirre, dude. He's my cousin. He's a fucking nut.
He's a Trumper?
Idiot.
Wow, hey, sorry, man. I didn't say that.
Sorry, Bobby. I mean, you're all right. He spanked me when I was a kid, so I've kind of still never forgot
him
for
that.
So
he's like older than you.
Yeah, he was my stepdad's age.
Ah, got
yeah.
It.
I mean, he won't watch this, dude.
Do you,
No offense, Bobby. I don't mean any disrespect.
Yeah, yeah.
But no, people. But then it's funny because they're like, you can't compare the things, and I'm like, okay, you actually can, you know. I went through and looked at like a lot of security measures that were enacted that Trump is just actually expanding upon from Obama, dude. Like
what
there
kind
was
of security measures.
Oh fuck, dude.
Like in regards to other countries, or
in regards to our own citizens as well. Like, did you know that the border, there is a constitution-free zone 100 miles in from the border.
What does that mean?
That means...
Where you can do whatever the fuck you want?
No, it means the Border Patrol can search you without a fucking warrant.
Oh, really?
Yeah. enacted under Obama. The No Trespassing Act. So if you cannot protest where a public servant, like a congressman, will be...
Mm-hmm.
Like in a state bill, you're not... They enacted a law like that where... If Secret Service, you can't be there protesting. If they wanted to, they could arrest you. Just for the right to assemble, peacefully assembly and protest.
Doesn't that seem reasonable, though, especially...
No, fuck no, it's not reasonable.
So if you're a politician and you're at dinner, let's say. This happened.
I know.
Somebody went in and they were harassing the politician so much,
it's happened to multiple people.
I say, I don't think that's fair, necessarily.
I don't think it's fair to harass people like that, but it's like, you need to fucking... If you're out in the public...
Right.
And somebody's like... Yo, why the fuck did you do this? You need to explain this to me. They need to explain it to them.
I agree with that, but I also think there's proper channels to talk to your politicians, and that's through like going to their government offices.
And how much usually gets done through that?
Nothing.
Exactly.
I can't say. I had an issue when I lived in the state of Kentucky, and I dealt with several people up the chain in politics there, from county to state, and... One of them is somebody who I dislike very, very, very much, who is the number two most unliked senator, congressperson, Mitch McConnell.
Oh, behind...
And he helped me.
Behind that gal?
Behind, Collins.
Well, I heard it's McSally now or whatever.
Well, because she was like, you liberal hack.
And it's like, just answer the question. That's what I'm talking about. It's like, just answer the fucking question. They're a reporter, and reporters do your job. I mean,
I think that McSally shit, like, I think there's a lot of these politicians that are literally... jumping on the Trump train and like just holding onto it so tight, so they're doing shit like that to sound like him, to go to his base, to get voted back in.
Yeah, for sure. But that's what you're doing, is you're destroying democracy.
I agree, because it's like being a rude dickhead to me. That's why there's all these people that are like, oh, I love how Trump's like, motherfucker, fuck you, goddamn.
Yeah, but if we did that to them, to their face,
right,
they'd be like, what the fuck are you doing that to me for? What, get the right fuck out of my face. And it's like, I'm gonna grab your wife by her pussy, bro.
Right, exactly.
Ooh, man.
It would... Well, he probably wouldn't care. He'd be like, Melania likes it.
Not from him.
I guess my problem is, like, I think there's a lot of people that dig what Trump's doing. And I can see part of it. I really can. The part that pisses me off, though, is that we've gone down such, like,
partisan,
nasty fucking drain of shit. Where it's like, I feel like most of the people on the left are saying dumb shit. But they're not being, like, crazy rude. Whereas people on the right are saying, oh, you liberal hack, and Trump's grabbing by the pussy and fuck him and hurt him and whatever. It's like, I just wish people would calm down. It's in the media too. Be a little more respectful. Chill out. We're all going to die one day. And I think one thing we could all agree on is we do want a better life, a better planet,
yeah,
for our kids, our kids' kids.
We do. Everybody, that's what everybody wants, that.
But we can't get on the same page because it's this whole going back to even, I think this is partially related to a tactic with the dark art bullshit.
Yeah.
It's like, it's divide and conquer, right?
Oh, yeah.
And
totally.
That thing that you posted on Facebook, how it talks about, I think it was that thing that talked about, you have the right and the left, but they're all working together. You have the right and the left, though, to keep us distracted and arguing down here. Meanwhile, they're all like, I bet you Mitch McConnell and Pelosi are friends because they're like, oh, dude, I got another $5 million last week. How about
it's
you?
You know what I mean? It's crazy. I mean, and that's an issue, too, is where it's like, you guys are public servants, and you're making ridiculous amounts of money.
Right.
I don't begrudge you for making money honestly, but you're not making money honestly. I mean, they can actually inside trade and not get busted for it.
Whereas you and I would go to jail
for it. Oh, we'd go to fucking jail for it.
Isn't that what Martha Stewart went to jail for?
Exactly.
She's a hard-ass bitch.
She hangs with Snoop.
I think we should say... You know, here's the thing, then. I wish people like Martha Stewart, Elon Musk, Sam Harris, even people like Warren Buffett... you don't like him?
I want
these people to be in power because they seem more thoughtful. They've been through... Martha Stewart being in prison, to me, has like... more
she would have actually threat. It would be probably proper prison reform,
right?
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Not the bullshit they have now, because it's like everything is geared towards,
well, prison is a business that'll never go away.
No, it won't go away because we do not have education. We don't promote reform. We don't promote, you know, real actual reform on prisoners. The prison industry is subsidized by the government,
right? And so what happens is you have people that are getting rich off having crowded prisons, and what's crazy about prisons is that there's people in prison for charges of like marijuana, and it's predominantly black and Hispanic that are in prison, and it's like, wow, okay, how come a white dude can get pulled over with this amount of pot and a black dude can get pulled over with that amount of pot and the black dude will get more prison time?
It's systematic racism.
I agree with that too. I mean I don't agree with it that I like it. I mean, I agree that that is a thing.
It's totally a thing.
God, don't you ever? I don't know. I get overwhelmed, man.
That's the thing. That's what I feel like this week. I started getting overwhelmed, and then when my friends on the left are like, "This is you need it," and it's like, "Now you're just making me kind of happy because now I'm gonna go look some shit up," and that's where I'm happy, is nerding out, looking stuff up. And so then I looked up some things, and I'm like, "You guys can't sway me. It's because you're invested with emotion, and emotions cloud judgment."
Ben Shapiro, you know who that is,
yep,
right? He's right-wing, Orthodox Jew.
Yep.
I love his tagline, though, is facts do not care about your feelings.
No.
And it's a fucking 100% true.
No.
Like, if you like the 49ers, that's because you like them. There's no...
Yo, bro. Actual.
It's my friend Jeanette's calling again.
Well, she needs to get off that tip. Jeanette, when you watch this, you don't call when we're on the air.
Don't send out our schedule. Do not just call during these times.
Well, phones do have silence now, especially that 11-12 plus you got.
It's 11 Pro, baby. This phone has yet to have had a crack.
I need to get... I've been on the hunt for a cover.
This is a minimal one, but I dig the look of it.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
But, you need one.
I'm scared,
You need one that floats.
Oh, looks like they're good.
What?
No, they're all right.
Well, you don't work yet. Well,
no, I don't work for a while.
You have like another 30 minutes.
No, I don't work till 2.
I thought today was 1.
No, 2.
I looked at your text.
Bro. My bad.
So what time do you work tomorrow then?
11. Football all day.
I work both days. 2 on... you did say 2 on Saturday.
Whoopsie.
1 on Sunday.
No. Wow. I'm not your wife. Don't skim over my text.
That's so fucking hilarious.
Lisa always gives me shit for... Did you read my text? I'm like...
See, I don't catch her phone, so I don't give a shit, and she doesn't...
No, not like reading, like picking up and reading the phone, but like when she sends me texts.
Oh, you'll go back through them?
No, I just like, if she sends me... Did you get that text? Like, I'll get home. Did you get the text? And I'm like, oh.
You just didn't look at your phone.
Yeah.
No, it's funny how long I hold on to text messages now. It's partially because of that. Like, I was going to go in and prove you wrong, but I proved myself wrong.
There you go.
But you said you work at 11 tomorrow. That says 1.
Well, I was wrong.
Oh, we were both wrong.
Yep.
Anyway, doesn't matter. I don't know, man. It's like, it trips me out with how much shit's going on. And then Jimmy Dore, man.
Yeah, I really, really liked him, dude. But he was saying, he made the statement, huh?
Did you listen to the Rogan podcast?
Yeah. That was the first time I'd ever heard him.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've listened to a bunch of his own show.
No, and I want to check him out, but I was really interested in him.
He loves Gabbard, Tulsi Gabbard.
So do I.
I'm a huge fan too.
Fuck yeah.
Anti-war. He was hoping that...
Bernie and Gabbard, dude.
Yeah, that's what he said.
That would
his
be...
His point about Bernie needs to stop being the nice old grandpa.
Yeah, he needs to come out and go, fuck you. Fuck you.
Fucked him, dude. The DNC fucked him with Hillary and all that.
Just capped him, but he's allowing them to just... run over him, and the whole debate where that whole Elizabeth Warren thing, that was a smear campaign against him.
They think that was staged too.
Oh, totally staged, and CNN was in on it.
Oh, you think so?
Oh, they totally said CNN. CNN leaked it. They were the ones who were, they were totally involved. It was a DNC smear thing.
Why do you think? I have a question then, because like that's something I really,
because there, it's one again, and people can get mad at me, and but I believe they're firmly is there's just one agenda. It doesn't matter who they're going to push. It's like
why would CNN or anybody else prefer Warren over Bernie, for example?
Her being a woman. I mean, I don't mean to do identity politics, but her being a woman.
That was a big part of it.
I think so. She's a liar, though,
who,
dude.
Who do you think the DNC is kind of pushing for right now?
They're gonna push. They're gonna push for.
Do you think it's gonna be like, let's say, Biden and Warren? Those will be like the final two.
I think they're gonna push Biden out finally.
Biden can't even speak full sentences anymore without stumbling all over his fucking ass. He's 77 years old, bro.
Well, they're all old. Well, Nancy Pelosi's almost 80 fucking years old.
I will give Elizabeth Warren this one thing. She's 70, but she looks like she's 50, bro. She looks young.
She's a tripper.
But she's a fucking cunt that lied about being an Indian.
Lied about being an Indian for all those, all that time. Well, it's a family story, and it's like, well, I remember, we were told the same thing. So I was like, yeah, we've got Indian in us, and it's like,
oh, you don't?
Not a drop, dude.
Well, she is like, what did she say? She's like
one 1600s or
it's like a fucking fraction of Mel. Joe Rogan always says, he goes, based on my 23andMe, I am way more black than she is Indian.
Yeah. I saw that.
That's so weird, man. Yeah, but it always trips me out who they push for, because bottom line is whoever gets in there, the first day in office, they take you into a room and they go, this is how it's going to be.
Yeah.
Like the military industrial complex.
Yeah.
Basically, people have talked about this too. So like,
Obama changed.
Right.
I mean, that's the thing too. And that's where people are getting mad at me. It's like, yo, go listen to Jimmy Dore. It's like he lays it out, like how
he hates Obama, like
how he did it. And it's like, it was just an expansion, like the Afghanistan papers that just came out.
I didn't see all
those. Oh, fuck, dude. So I'm just starting to read those.
What's the gist of that?
We have been fucking lying the whole time we've been in Afghanistan. Like, they're like, we don't even know who the fuck we're fighting. You know, they just create a war against terrorism.
Right.
And it's like, Al-Qaeda, we're doing you because, you know, you harbored, or we're doing the Taliban because you harbored Al-Qaeda.
Right.
But then now it's like, oh, we're in talks with the Taliban.
Oh, well, that's been going on forever. It's like
Afghanistan is our longest running fucking war. Remember this, people.
Because that started right after 9/11.
Yep.
Basically, like, so that was 2000.
Longer than Vietnam.
So, yeah. Well, but nowhere near the number of deaths as Vietnam.
Based on our deaths.
Media tell us. Right, no, our deaths.
Yeah.
But we don't care about other countries dying.
No.
I mean, we kind of do, but nobody else does. The media doesn't.
No.
I have a question for
you. It's a narrative, and the media pushes the narrative. He said as well, like, the media pushes the narrative of war. It's like, the media will get this nationalistic thing behind them and push fucking war, because it's good for their business as well.
So, do you think politicians on both sides of the aisle benefit from when we're in war, and it's a financial benefit?
Oh yeah, they either hold stock in companies.
Got it. Oh, especially like what Dick Cheney with Halliburton.
Halliburton,
our
current fucking defense Secretary of Defense was with Raytheon before he came here. With Raytheon, and then now he's here, Department of Defense. You don't think that dude's fucking?
He's got you. No, he's got.
Or doing contracts or right. Any of that shit.
100%.
100%, dude.
So other than that, so then also in war, we're clearly during the times of.
And then, well, even in, so war is good for, we build bases when there's wars.
We build bases. We build equipment.
We build equipment. Planes. So you have to keep that shit going. You've got, you've got Burger King's, McDonald's on these bases. So it's like,
oh, so that even gets tied into like
you're feeling,
regular economic corporations.
Oh, for sure, dude. And that's who do you? Yeah. So think about that. How they're involved? No, come on in.
What?
She's like behind. Cody, guys, Cody.
I didn't realize that she was so scared.
It's because she's not drunk. I'm just kidding. I didn't say you.
Oh, are you?
No. Not yet.
There's still time.
Yeah, it's a long day.
What time is it?
Best line in a movie is Kingpin. keep them tanker rays coming. I got a long drive ahead of me.
The bowling movie?
Yeah, Bill Murray.
Dude, I need to go watch that again because I've seen that like a dozen times.
It's a good one.
It was so funny, dude.
But
wasn't
so
Randy Quaid in that one?
Oh, yeah. He was the Amish pro bowler. But yeah, so everybody's making dough, and that's where I equate them all being the fucking same. We can squabble about, you know, how awful
your
the
party,
Republicans are.
Party,
yeah,
they're all doing it all
day long, and it's crazy. I mean, the main gist is people in power want to consolidate their fucking power. That's, I mean, I 100% believe
well,
that.
They spend a shit ton of their time consolidating their power, but I mean trying to protect it too, so it can't be taken away.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then they start doing weird shit, like that congressman years ago that was like playing footsies with an undercover cop.
Yeah, and seeing that it goes along with the thing where he thinks I can get away with anything.
Right.
And it's like, dude, just go get a fucking blowjob. Hire a dude and go get your fucking dick sucked.
Here's the problem then. I think what it almost seems, I know you said this last week, but to me it seems so big and unstoppable. Like that that huge locomotive coming at you, going a million miles an hour.
That's fast.
And, yeah, I mean, it's like light speed. How do you stop it? But that's like, how do you stop the military-industrial complex? How do you stop this whole, like, fanaticism behind nationalism again, where I feel like it should... I don't like nationalism.
I don't either.
Fuck the borders. I'm not saying fuck the borders and don't defend them. Defend them. I just... Yeah, it's hard to fuck a border. But I just really feel like we're human.
Unless it's like the border of a panty. You can fuck the border of that.
Slider it in.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a good point.
You can't fuck borders, people.
I just got off topic. Yeah, man, it's a bummer to me, dude. It's like, there just seems to be so much fucking hate, and like, it's us against them. It's fuck that side.
Well, but didn't you just, you know what? You just try and be good and just do what you can to help. If it's within your power to do good, do it.
Does doing this shit, like talking about this like we do sometimes, like is it cathartic for you, or does it kind of get you ramped up?
Both.
Oh, that's not good.
No, it's good. It's totally good because, like I said, it makes me go look for stuff and then go, okay.
Oh, it makes you want to educate yourself more.
Exactly.
Unlike most of the people that scroll through Facebook and only like the shit.
Oh, or
they're preconceived.
Or they don't even read the articles, and it's like.
Oh, it's like, click. Yeah, they're like, oh, look at that headline. It's pro-Trump. Click.
Or pro-whatever.
Yeah.
Click.
Pro-Hillary.
So, yeah, I mean, I get ramped up, but like I said, I like going and digging deep, and so then I this morning was looking up just different things that were passed, and I'm like, Obama passed that shit, and I'm like, geez, man, that guy was
crazy,
fucking
right?
Well, and he tripled the military, or no, it wasn't tripled. That's an exaggeration. He did expand the military budget.
What?
Why do we have a fucking military budget that is so fucking huge?
Well, they say if you cut our military budget in half, somebody said this.
It's still bigger than China.
It's still bigger than the next closest country.
Which is China.
Right. So, yeah, Obama, with that, wasn't it Jimmy Dore said that when Obama got into office, we were in two wars, and he got us into four more wars?
Yeah.
And I would not be able to name all those because I'm uninformed. Not to change the subject.
Change it.
Get this shit, dude.
Let's get it.
There's no dark art here.
Okay.
Big Bang may have created a mirror universe where time runs backwards.
That's sick.
This is so crazy, though. They're literally saying...
They don't know.
It's like, why... No, but it's like all these hypotheses based on tests they can do in labs with, like, particles and all this shit.
Yeah, but what happened before the Big Bang?
I mean, who the fuck knows? No, before the Big Bang, it was like everything...
What caused the bang?
Two leading theories proposed to explain the direction of time by way of the relatively uniform conditions of the Big Bang. At the very start, what is now the universe was homogeneously hot, so much so that matter didn't really exist. It was all just a superheated soup. But as the universe expanded, cooled, stars and galaxies, planets and other celestial bodies formed, birthing the universe's irregular structure and raising its entropy. Do you understand any of that shit?
Sort of, but no.
When I read that, though, I was like, wait, so there's, like, potentially a... Because, you know, like, Big Bang,
mm-hmm.
We come out...
One end, it goes out the other end. But they say that black holes could be the... Those are the formations of new dimensions. Like, actual new... So for every black hole, what gets sucked in and spit back out becomes a completely different dimension, universe, with universes in it. Everything.
Not like time travel, but something like that. In a
it's
sense.
It's what it's a completely different dimension that you can't fucking see.
Which is funny too, because
then it's a whole new other universe,
right?
Interdimensional.
Don't they say there's like infinite universes though?
Yeah, and that's where it's part of that
how
too.
How the fuck is that? And these are like little portals.
Yeah.
So you could bounce around like you do in that Guardians of the Galaxy shit.
For sure. I mean, once you get the technology to do it, for sure.
Because they said a long time ago, I remember when I was in like junior high, they said humans would die if they went into a black hole.
Yeah, they said you get ripped apart and it's like, well, it's going to take fucking 100,000 years, but whatever.
I wonder what the... there are black holes in our universe.
There's one in our universe.
Is it least. Like, is it near Earth or some other?
No, I mean...
Is it just out there?
It's pretty far out there, but it is in our universe for sure.
God,
or
man,
galaxy.
Deep fucking episode.
Not really.
Dark arts, black holes, and there's a reverse, time goes backwards.
Well, it's all, I mean, if you, do you watch Rick and Morty?
No.
Watch that shit, dude. It totally is all about...
Is that like a TV show thing?
It's a cartoon, but it's fucking so well written.
Really?
Yeah.
Like better than South Park?
It's par with South Park.
Okay, got it.
It's par with South Park, dude. It's this genius grandpa, Rick, who fucking takes his grandson, Morty, on all these intergalactic and interdimensional adventures, and he's a raging alcoholic.
Oh, good. That's awesome.
He's always got fucking drool coming out of his mouth, and he's burping.
But he's a genius?
Oh, he created like interdimensional time shit and all. Wow. He's awesome. He's the Rickest Rick I know.
That's a t-shirt.
Well, it is. It totally is. Because they have a whole thing on, man, if I'm the Rickest Rick, then that means you're the Mortiest Morty.
That's good.
Because you can't have a Rick without a Morty. They counterbalance each other.
Well, there wouldn't be the show.
Because Morty's stupid, but then he's getting all smart, and then there's evil Morty from a different universe.
Like came through a black hole?
It's pretty wild. But yeah, it's the same concept.
I'll check it out.
It's a good one. Good one. But yeah, so I mean, this week's been like that. You know, it was the Dodgers impeachment shit. That okay? So all the grandstanding for when they signed the impeachment papers was stupid.
Yes, it was.
Like Nancy Pelosi was acting like she was a fucking president. Like when he does his, you were just like Trump, and so. Using a pen to sign that shit and giving that stuff out.
Oh,
it's not a joyful fucking...
No, it's not.
Oh, we're impeaching him. It's like a fucking solemn thing.
But when you're president and you're signing a bill into law, that is something to celebrate.
If it's a good one, well, but he's done so many national...
But clearly that party thing...
Like his executive orders, he does that same shit. Oh, yeah.
Right. Oh, well, Obama did all the same shit, too.
For sure.
Here's a pen.
And how much fucking money of my money... Well, I don't really pay taxes. How much of my fucking money... How much of my money or your money is being spent on that shit?
Everything that we give to them.
Stupid.
I mean, I'm self-employed, so I don't make a lot of money.
Me either.
We'd like to make more money if anybody wants to hire us for anything, really.
Sponsor us. Give us your money. What else is going on? What's going on in the world of wine?
I don't know. That whole wine speak thing was... That event was going on.
What do you think of that?
I've never partaken in it. I don't...
You didn't get to go for media?
No, dude, you know what's funny... Okay, I have something interesting to tell you.
Okay.
What's the date?
19th. The 18th. 18th. Damn, yeah, I lost a day.
I saw Drew walk in. 10 years ago, right around this date, is when Annie and I started our blog, and it was all focused on wine. Yeah. And I'll be honest, I still drink wine. I still love wine. It's still fun. We don't go out wine tasting as much as we used to. I don't go to wine events really anymore at all. I don't know. Like, I just... I had a fear of missing out thing, though, that happened, like, over the last year where I was, like, something like this would come into town, and it's like, oh, I really want to be a part of that. Look at all those people. But then it's like, you wouldn't have fun if you went, Matt.
It's the same, well, to me...
You know what I mean?
It's the same fucking people, dude.
Right.
It's just, we're going to go, we're going to be seen, we're doing the super cool thing. And no offense, hey, you guys set it up. Hey, buddy. It was set up, but it's like, I personally don't know really anybody who was, like... Oh, you know, like real industry people who work in fucking bars, who work in tasting rooms. Maybe they took their staffs. I don't know.
I don't know either.
What's up, baby?
Maybe.
Doing
what's
good,
up,
man.
Happy Saturday.
Happy Saturday.
I just, to me, it's... You want to, like I posted, if you want to fucking, you want to know what hospitality service is, come work right. In Tent City. Come get a job down here somewhere.
On a busy
Saturday.
Yep.
And if you can still give great service and smile at the end of the day and people are stoked... And you survive, because it gets gnarly sometimes. That, to me, is fucking hospitality.
Right.
That is like, you're doing it, you're actually doing it.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not...
To me, I feel like it's geared towards, like, high-end restaurants, high-end wineries.
And geeks. Just wine geeks.
I guess. I mean,
Cody, come on.
Where's Cody?
She just walked in.
Oh.
And she was like looking to see if we were still doing it because she wants to go dump a bucket out or some shit.
She wants to go take a dump?
Tell her the video's not working properly that she can come out.
Cody's gonna take a dump in a bucket?
Dump bucket. Pretty sure she loves that you said that on here.
Well, you should have came out then. So whatever. I mean,
if you guys are into it.
But yeah, how about it?
When I see an event like that, I think a lot of the people that partake in it, whether you're as a consumer, the people that partake in it, I just think in any community, this one included, you just have a lot of people that want to be seen. They want to be where the cool kids are. Oh, is that Justin from Saxon? I'm going to go say hi and get a photo with them, and I don't give a fuck. I mean, I've walked up to Justin at an event before. It was a very small event, so it was easier. And I just walked up and said, hey, bro, I'm Matt. I help Mush Charities out with their social media. I know you're a contributor to them. Just wanted to say hi. Can I get a couple videos of you for Mush Charities?
There you go.
And that was, like, I'm not going to, like, go over there and hump him, like, you know, try to pee on his leg to mark my territory. Like, but that's what I see a lot of.
I totally see that,
where,
dude.
There's just, like, it reminds me of high school where it was like, look at my best friend. She's the captain of the cheerleading squad. Fuck her. She's a whore. She slept the whole football team.
Did she?
I mean, probably. Wouldn't she?
That's, you don't know that, dude. You're slut shaming, dude.
I am.
You're slut shaming.
I love being so. Fuck all the nonsense.
What if she likes fucking all the time?
What if she's a virgin and she never fucked and I just totally called her out?
Yeah. You're slut.
Do you think that the head cheerleader of a high school cheerleading team could be a virgin? I mean, mouth, puss, and ass.
Oh.
Virgin.
All three?
No.
Yeah, no, you can not touch it. No. She hasn't sucked no dick.
There's girls that are like only doing this, and they're like, oh, I'm a virgin. I've never had sex.
Or
like,
the Mormon gals will take it up the butt. Oh, you got a haircut, dude. Yeah. Looks good.
Take the hat off.
Mormon gals will take it up the old culo and say, so, I'm still a virgin.
The cheerleading head girl.
We're talking about high schoolers.
Yeah, high schoolers.
16, 17 years old. Do you think their mouth is a virgin?
No.
These days?
I don't even think back in our days.
I didn't get a lot of blowjobs when I was in high school.
Holy smokes, man. That's a conversation.
Well, I didn't get a lot of blowjobs when I was in high school.
No, I think you walked in at the right time.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't get a lot of blowjobs.
I don't even know what cheerleader I'm talking about. I just said that.
There were some cheerleaders I wanted to bone in high school, for sure. But the way I was, I wasn't even looked at, so.
Why?
Because I was totally, I was.
Were you like a stoner back then, or just like the
Stoner, skater, surfer.
Girls love that shit. Maybe not back then. They love that shit today.
Yeah, today. But I wasn't a typical, I mean.
Were you religious back then?
No.
Oh, so a bigger plus too.
Yeah, so I mean, when I was, because like the surfers all had a look. When I was in high school, you all had
shaggy hair,
shaggy blonde hair,
tank tops, shorts, flip flops.
Yeah, that, or you know, they just looked like fucking surfers. I had a
super
shaved
tan
head.
Oh,
you know,
you were one of those people.
Yeah, I would shave my head. You know, freshman year I had long hair and then I cut it all off, and then I had a shaved head, and then when I was a skater all the time, that just was not, that was frowned upon.
That's so weird.
It was you were just totally, you were
must
just,
have been different times because
this is the mid 80s, dude.
So wait, when you were in high school?
I graduated in 80, well, my last year I think it was 87.
I graduated in 94.
Yeah, so 87, but so all through high school, I should have graduated 86, truthfully.
I mean,
but it doesn't
matter.
How
you said truthfully, like anybody gives a fuck.
They don't give a fuck. They don't give a fuck.
No, like when I was in high school, it was like the sports guys.
Yeah.
It was all clicky, dude. There was like the goth people that would go up to the park at lunch and smoke weed. You had like the pricky sports fuckers who are all probably fucking overweight and losers now in life, right? Like, it just...
You don't know if they're losers.
Yes, every fucking one of them.
That's generalization again, dude. I was just talking to someone last night how we were talking how I feel like I'm the one who's like, yeah, that's just, that's, you know... Be a little positive about those people.
Father time, bro. You get some wisdom on you.
And you're all, fuck them!
Fuck them! No, it's... I don't know, man. It's,
There's a lot of people I want to say fuck it to, but it's like... It's pointless. What will it accomplish?
They don't give a fuck anymore.
No, a lot of people don't.
Because after you do it, you're like... And you, like... Let's say we both called out, like, five people each from our past, and we were like, dick, dick, dick.
Oh, I was... Last night, I saw a guy on Facebook. His popped up, and I was like, fuck that guy.
Why are you friends with him on Facebook?
I'm not friends with him, but it's like suggested friends.
Oh. Okay.
And I was like, dude, you fucking pushed my face into a fountain in seventh grade. I don't like you. I still don't like you.
I'm going to tell you right now, Facebook is an asshole with how they do that suggest a friend. Fuck you. If I want to be friends with somebody, I'll meet them, and then I'll join them on Facebook.
Yeah, I would love to have that fucking dude. Whatever. Maybe he's
did
changed.
Did you ever beat him up at back or do anything?
No, we fucking did not like each other, though. He was part of Oceano Clique.
Clique?
He was a gangster kid.
Oh, I thought you were calling him gay.
He's gay. He went to prison. Well, he cheesed on some motherfucker, so he didn't go to prison.
Is his name Ricky?
No, I'm not saying his name, but he was a fucking cheese hound.
Scott?
Nope.
Felipe.
No, dude. He knows who he is. He fucking...
You think he watches this?
Well, him and this other dude that was in high school with shot this kid.
Shot a kid?
Yeah, shot him. They were little gangsters.
On purpose?
Uh-huh. They had to prove themselves. And,
In Oceano, you have to prove yourself?
They were like gangsters down, going to Santa Maria and fucking beefing with those kids or... Just stupid shit. But then...
That's so fucking gnarly.
He fucking cheddar cheesed.
So he gave everybody up and didn't have to do any jail time after shooting a guy?
I think he maybe did some county time because he didn't pull the trigger or some shit.
Woo! That's so nuts, dude.
Rat bastards. Well, that's... Trump won't give up Pelosi. Pelosi won't give up Trump. They just...
What do you mean, though? What do they have on each other?
They won't get... Crime families don't fucking...
Oh, right. No,
cheese on each other.
Right, that goes back to what I said earlier, whereas, especially in politics, I think they're all working together.
Yeah, they don't cheese on each other.
They may not agree with each other on stuff, but they're all playing that same get-rich game and have power, and they're not going to give it up. So, like, yeah. Even with this impeachment shit, it's like...
Smoke and mirrors.
Jimmy Dore brought that shit up, too. Like, how come... He laid out his reasoning why she didn't go to impeach Bush, yet she's willing to impeach Trump on way less shit than what... Bush got us into a massive fucking war over WMDs that didn't exist.
Well, then Congress has the power of the fucking purse.
Right.
Why don't you just go, no?
That was the other thing Dore said that was hilarious, is that... So they're trying to impeach him, and then during this, they also came up with a new budget that gave him even more money for military.
Yeah.
But what the... I'm confused, people.
Exactly. That's not being bipartisan. That's fucking raping.
And they do it on both sides.
That's rapey.
Left and the right.
Super rapey.
Very rapey.
So I just want to say shit when you come in now.
There are no cheerleaders at Virgins, by the way.
That's not true, man.
Name one. Can you name one? What?
I don't hang out with cheerleaders, so I can't. I mean, and I'm too... If I hung out with cheerleaders right now, dude, that'd be weird.
Why'd they look in here?
That's Coley. Hey. Yeah, we want lemons.
You don't need to be afraid.
Totally want lemons. Are these apricots or lemons? Quetch. Oh, shit, yeah.
They're from Otis.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Vitamin C.
But they're almost all gone. I guess I'll save the rest for...
There you go.
Here.
Where did you get them at?
Some guy. Some dude.
Some random.
Came in and pulled it out of his anal cavity.
Sweet. Wow, that's... Why do I want to eat that, then?
You're doing it.
Well...
I mean, I didn't witness
his butthole
that.
Smells good, dude. That butt smells good.
It smells like fruit. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm a... Woo!
Oh, that's probably really good with vodka.
Yeah, that's tart.
Oh, man.
So...
Yeah, that whole...
What's good this week, though? Let's end this... What's good this week?
What's good this week? I think I talked about it last week. When did we podcast? What day last week?
Last Sunday. Remember, I tripped out. I ended up fucking shrooming all day long.
Oh, did you?
Uh-huh.
I don't know. For me, I kind of always go back to my kid, man. He's 7. He's fucking awesome. Super funny. He has his flag football tomorrow.
Yeah.
Down at Cal Poly. And he appears to have a good team after last week's win of 50-6.
This other kid sucked.
Yeah, they either sucked or were really good. One of the... Or both. I don't know, what really good... I don't know, it was kind of an off week for me, man. Like, I spent a lot of time, like, just being quiet, not really chatting. Annie and I both worked from home, and I would just kind of be... I was broody.
I guess I was a little bit, too. I mean, I worked all week.
Here,
Lisa's still been sick. Yeah, because I'm working... I had her birthday off, and then...
She was sick for that.
she was sick, and then we were gonna do so. She's leaving tomorrow to go up to the food show. Fancy, fancy food show. Yeah, it's at the Moscone Center. It's a dope show, for sure. I've been before.
That's cool. She's going to that.
She's going with that though.
Or what?
Yeah. What's up, Tommy? Tommy Stein, people. Hungry mother truck. Where are you gonna be next week?
I'll have to check my calendar. Talk to my boss lady.
All right. Just wanted to give you so we can tell them, so when they see this, they'll know where you're at next week.
We'll post about it early in the week, and it'll be on our website. HungryMotherTruck.com.
HungryMotherTruck.com. Get at him, folks.
Fully updated website.
Fully updated website.
Or catch him on Facebook, because he posts all that shit there, too.
Yeah. He doesn't. His wife does, dude.
Oh, his wife.
Yeah, on the gram, too. Yeah.
I know she's on the gram, dude. Got to get those gifts up there. That's awesome.
Yeah, I don't know, man. It's, yeah, just been a weird week. Nothing bad happened. I think I have been going down too many rabbit holes lately.
With what?
Just, I've gotten back into, I don't watch the news on TV, but I'll listen to it on, just over our Alexa. I've been down rabbit holes with different podcasts, the ones that we've talked about.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. Work is going decent. It could be better. That's the same for everybody, right? Yeah, I don't know. I'm not, like, not depressed or anything, just, it was a week. I mean, super happy that I'm healthy and alive, and...
Are you guys going to the Tamale Festival?
No, I thought that, when is that?
Today.
Oh, no. No, man, I don't know, it's like, I don't know, we're either in San Luis...
Oh!
What?
You know what I want to tell you, did you see Patrick Weinstein? They're doing a fucking... Uh-uh. Oh, boy.
What are they doing?
They're doing a sit-down interview type thing. Oh, I'll show you right now.
Wait, like, they're doing, like...
It's, like, full production, dude.
Like, at Weinstein?
I don't know where they're doing it.
It's like, him? Like, he's doing, like, a video podcast-y type thing?
Mm-hmm.
What's, like, the... Like, is it... Wow, you have a lot of security on your phone.
Jeez. I do. Not really.
You have to keep Lisa out?
No. She knows my passcode.
What do they talk about? Like, what's happening?
Where was it? I'll show you. No, it was on Instagram.
So they're doing IGTV?
No, they are doing,
I'm just looking at other shit right now.
Here we go. I dropped my phone.
I'm not. What in the fuck?
You want me to show you how to interview Patrick? Come on down, bud.
Welcome, everyone. My name is Patrick Brooks, and I'm here at the brand new EPR studio to talk to you.
Where are these studios, dude?
I don't know.
I want to use them.
In the hot seat right here, I'm going to have all sorts of guests, anything from winemakers to chefs to brewers.
Look at what I wrote.
Distillers to talk about.
Sweet, let me co-host and talk about you.
Drinking community with farming problems.
It's all good. Oh my god. Wow, dude. So he
EPR Studios. I want to know about that.
EPR?
Yeah.
Let's find out. Let's go right now. EPR.
EPR Studios.
Paso Robles?
Yeah.
EPR Studios, Paso Robles. Only one thing comes up, and I think it's that video.
Yeah.
It has 7 views.
I viewed it. Oh, there. Oh, the music's different on this one.
Is that not the same video, though?
Yeah, it totally is.
Well, we'll see, I guess.
Everything is a multi-camera, multimedia company helping with your...
So, I wonder if he's using that company. Oh, no, this isn't the same video.
Oh, this is
who, them.
Yeah. You need to talk to him, dude. You need to talk to them. You're the tech guy. Get at that.
Yeah, I'll talk to them. Make this shit all... You know, you'll pay for it, too.
Yeah.
There's going to be money behind that shit.
I know. We'll see. Have to see. We'll just see how much that is first, though.
Yeah. Whoa, careful, bro. That's hilarious, though. Patrick's starting a little show. Dude, it's the way to go, man. People want to fucking talk and hang out and, like...
They do. They want to hear what people have to say and not just a... bites, but I do like the bites thing. But long format on, you know, multiple subjects.
The short clips of a long format thing are great to get people enticed into the thing.
You know, yeah.
Like, for sure. Because like, what you could do is share the clip, and then in the commentary, you could add the link to the full podcast.
Yeah.
A friend of mine also, shout out to Brandy in Florida, a friend of mine who let me know about a way. It's a something that she's some website you can go and you can take an MP4, which is video, and it'll extract the audio off of it into an MP3.
Oh, cool.
So I should, once I get that up and going, we'll have full video on YouTube and then full audio for SoundCloud, Spotify, iTunes.
All those places.
Yeah. Well, those are the three I want to do, and then video obviously will be YouTube. She's super helpful.
That's awesome. That's good.
That's a good thing. That helped. Yeah, that's my good thing. So what's your good thing for the week? Or are you going to leave it open like it hasn't happened yet? Like today?
Yeah, it could have totally happened, you know? Oh, I got laid this week. That was a good thing.
Way to go, Lisa!
Appreciate that.
That's a good thing.
Yeah, totally a good thing.
We should have Patrick on our show.
We should, dude. I feel like, I mean, I want to see what, like, who he has and what they do and talk about. And it's like, if it's going to be tame or if it's going to be like fucking no hold barred, say whatever the fuck you want.
I have a feeling it won't be that, because I think when you have brands like that, people don't want to fuck with their brands. Like let's say he wants it to be no holds barred, but then like Jason Haas comes on from Tobler's Creek. Jason's not going to get rowdy because
he's too chill.
He's a chill guy, but he's wants to keep the brand in line. And I makes sense. Whereas, I love Patrick. He's got a great personality. I totally think he can pull it off. I don't like that super polished look. I like that, like, fuck, this is it. We're outside. We're in here. We're mobile. We're not... I don't know. I dig it. I just... The simplicity of our equipment, the fact that we have mics now that, like, will work.
Is, woo! Woo!
Nobody looked.
They all suck.
Fuck everybody.
No, they're all the good.
Everybody's fine.
They're all good.
This is number 27.
27, guys.
Which is only three away from 30, bro.
Three away from 30, bro. Only
three away from 50. You think we'll make it to 50?
I think so.
I mean, as long as one of us doesn't die.
Yeah.
I think now that we've been talking about all this fucking weird dark art shit, we gotta be careful.
I think so, too. I get them all serious. I think so, too.
I think Hillary watches this shit. She's got some hitmen in her back pocket.
She's got Kevin Spacey to do her shit for.
Dude, you see that? What happened to him? He released a video.
Yeah, I know, that day, and then that guy committed suicide.
Right. What's up with that?
Dark arts. Join the resistance.
What he said.